Hello everyone, it's your host on Just Cradlers from on Just Cradlin. Today we will be taking another look at the Big Book of Animals, and so let's go to the table of contents to see what we previously read. So what we previously read in the book was we read about shrews and small insect borers. And so today we will be reading about anteaters, armadillos, and sloths. Let's dive right into it. Which means that there we are. Anteaters, armadillos, and sloths. Anteaters, aardvarks, armadillos, pangolins, and sloths share several features. All have powerful front legs with long claws used for digging or hanging onto tree branches and reduced or absent teeth. The two largest animals in this group, anteaters, South America, and aardvarks, Africa, are interesting because although they prey on tiny insects, neither is a small animal. The giant anteater weighs as much as 80 pounds and the aardvark almost twice as much at 140 pounds, both known as ant bears in the countries where they live. The explanation in their hunting strategy. Instead of looking for one insect at a time, anteaters and aardvarks learn the location of ant and termite nests or mounds. So the explanation is the hunting strategy. We're going to learn more about it. Because these are social insects, each nest contains hundreds of thousands of them. Ant bears move from one nest to another, digging a hole in each and eating what they can without getting stung too badly. The worker ants or termites repair the damage, and the nest is still there for the next visit. Lifespans for the animals in this group range from 10 to 25 years. First, let's do the giant anteater. They live in Central and South America from Belize to Argentina. They are 40 to 86 pounds or 18 to 39 kilograms, and they eat ants, termites, and grubs. Inside its 1.5 foot or 0.5 meters long snout, the giant anteater has a 2 foot 0.6 meters long tongue and no teeth. It also has glands that produce sticky saliva. To feed, it flicks its tongue 150 times a minute, grabbing its food. You have the large hairy armadillo. They live in Paraguay, Bolivia, and central Argentina. They are about 4.4 pounds or 2 kilograms, and they eat insects, other invertebrates, small rodents, lizards, plants, and carrion. Armadillos have armor-like skin to protect themselves when threatened. This protective layer is made up of flat bones or scutes covered by keratin, the same material that makes up hair and nails. We have Hoffman Two Tors Sloth. They live in Central and South America. They are 8.8 to 17.7 pounds or 48 kilograms, and they eat leaves, twigs, and fruit. The sloth's curved toes help it hang onto tree branches without wasting energy. All species of sloth are similar. They eat leaves, buds, and twigs, move very slowly, and climb to the ground weakly to defecate. They rarely drink water. We have collared anteater. They live in South America. They are 9.9 pounds or 4.5 kilograms, and they eat ants and termites. This species has two other names, lesser anteater or southern tamandua. It spends its time in the trees feeding on ants. Though much smaller than its giant cousin, the tamandua also has a very long tongue, up to 1.3 feet or 0.4 meters long. So we have, now we go to the next page to look at more. Pale throated three toed sloth. They live in Central and South America. They are 4.9 to 12.1 pounds or 2.2 to 5.5 kilograms, and they eat twigs, buds, and leaves. Because they live in the rainforest and rarely move, sloths often grow algae on their food. The relationship is an example of communalism, which means the algae has a place to live and the sloth is better camouflaged. The algae may even be nutritious. Indian pangolin. They live in eastern Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka. They are 11 to 77 pounds or 5 to 35 kilograms. And they mainly eat termites, ants, and ant eggs. Pangolins are covered in armor-like scales made of clumps of hair. Like anteaters, they have a very long tongue and no teeth. Like birds, they have a thick stomach wall that grinds up their food. And then here's the image. And last, the southern two-toed sloth. They live in Central and South America. They are 8.8 to 17.6 pounds or 4 to 8 kilograms. And they eat leaves, twigs, and fruit. Because their diet, sloths have a slow metabolism and cannot maintain a high body temperature. So like reptiles, they move into the sun when they need to get warm. Their digestion is the slowest of any herbivorous mammal, up to 2.5 days. Now for our biggest and smallest animal. We are taking a look. We're taking a look. We're taking a look. We're taking a look. We're taking a look. Taking a look, taking a look, taking a look. Okay, looks like it's in. The smallest in our group today is the large hairy armadillo. Well, it's maybe the smallest, but who knows? It's about that much according to what we know. And for sure, the largest is the giant anteater. Sometimes it could be smaller than the Indian pangolin, but even though you may think the Indian pangolin is larger, nope, it's the giant anteater. Okay, thanks for watching. Be sure to follow me on my social media. These will also be posted. But I hope you had fun reading. Thanks for watching. Come back for the next one.